Well, it's been 50 years since the crew of the final Apollo mission stepped foot on the moon. That was in 72. And now NASA has launched the first Artemis rocket, first Artemis mission, a project that will return Americans to the moon in the coming years.
On Wednesday, Apollo 17 lunar modular pilot Harrison Schmitt visited the U.S. Space and Rocket Center and provided insight into NASA's journey back to the lunar surface. News 19's Kayla Smith is joining us now with the details about his visit. Kayla.
Steve, Kelly, astronaut Harrison Schmitt was a professional geologist, the only one to ever step foot on the moon, and his lunar mission placed a heavy emphasis on scientific experiments and research, something he says will play a major role in the future of Artemis. Schmitt says the samples he helped collect on the moon in 1972 have now contributed to several generations of research, and it's time for astronauts to go back. But he says NASA faces several challenges that didn't exist during the Apollo missions. For example, the private sector is working to push space technology forward, and NASA has to work to integrate that tech with Artemis. But as much as things change, they stay the same. Schmitt says the average age of the people that made Apollo 17 a possibility was 26, and it's young people, many who learn right here in the Rocket City, who are pushing research and development forward today.
A space camp starts to germinate within them, I think the enthusiasm and the interest, not only in space, but in doing great things with their lives. And whether they go in or do space or not is not so important as stimulating in them the desire to do great things. And every event that it takes in order to successfully land on the moon represents something that has to go successfully. So that Apollo learned that. It's time, I think, for another generation not only to learn it, but to take it on as their challenge.
NASA has plans to send an Artemis mission to the south pole of the moon, something Schmitt says is a very different challenge from where he and his crew landed. He says a lot of work will go into preparing for that objective, and while he cautions restraint, he's looking forward to the future of the Artemis program. And the Orion spacecraft is currently making its way back to Earth. Splashdown is set to happen this Sunday in the Pacific Ocean at 11:40 a.m. local time. Live this morning, Kayla Smith, News 19.